There are two technologies that I believe are going to have significant impact on our society and banking specifically. The first one of those is the use of personal data, what I call small data, to meet the needs of customers. In fact, to personalize the offer and anticipate their needs. Banks have more data about their customers than any other type of organization in the world. To date, they haven't been able to access that data because it lives in data jails throughout their back offices, or their vendors do not offer products that can do that. Now there's a whole generation of fintechs coming out that can in fact deliver data analysis and push it forward to personalize and anticipate customers' needs. That's very important because customers expect that. Another piece of technology that we're already using in our home that's going to have a profound effect on banks is voice-enabled interfaces to personal assistants. 24% of Americans already have a Google Home, a Siri, an Alexa. 40% of that 24% have more than one. So these devices are out there and they're going to grow in popularity because they represent such a simple, easy, frictionless type of interface. And it is already the fact that some banks can provide, through Alexa, someone's deposit balance. And that's going to become payments at some point when biometrics enter into it and you can authenticate somebody by voice. It's a Star Trek effect. We're not going to be satisfied with having to use our digits in order to get computers to do things. We're going to be satisfied when we can speak to them and they can give us whatever we need. The potential impact for these technologies has to do with making particularly community banks more competitive. Since the iPhone, $2.4 trillion of deposits have flown into the top three banks. Those deposits have come out of smaller banks, and mainly because the larger banks offer the customers a better digital experience on the whole. Using data in order to personalize and anticipate the experience the consumer had will neutralize that advantage. So if a community bank can unlock that potential, they'll add leverage to their advantage in the marketplace. As far as the voice interface goes, it's the same thing. Large banks spend millions, if not billions of dollars on enhancing their mobile experience. They have scores and scores of coders that they can afford. Competing with that by a smaller bank is just not going to happen. But when you talk about voice interfaces, the color of the app, the flow of the app, that all goes away. It all gets neutralized, and a bank, a community-sized bank, then is on equal footing with a larger bank. Well, when I talk to mid-tier and community banks about voice or data analytics, many of them think it's really outside their scope, that that's something only big banks can do. The truth of the matter is, this technology is incredibly flexible, affordable, and simple to use, and available in the marketplace. I believe that if you're not a bank today, a mid-tier community bank, and you aren't looking at new technical tools and finding out from your vendor where those are in their product and looking at new vendors that have it, and considering these new types of services like data analytics and voice interfaces, that you're missing a trick. These are the very tools that will give you the opportunity to not only retain your customers, but to grow your customer base, because they already prefer to bank at community banks. The only reason they're taking their deposits to the big banks is that they don't have the digital experience that they want, and that's not going to go away.